Christopher Rosie from VHI Hydraulics. And hi, Chris, how are you?
Fine, thanks. And you?
Very good. So it's afternoon in Italy now, right now, right?
Yes.
How do you say good afternoon in Italian?
Buon pomeriggio.
Oh, that's very long. All right, very good. Okay, very good. So you're going to talk to us about solenoid actuator four-stroke curve estimation. I believe you're going to be talking about the use of EMS. So.
Yes.
So you are now the presenter. You can go ahead and click on share screen.
Yes. Can you see my screen?
Yes, we do now.
Okay. So good morning or good evening, depending on where
I'm here
from.
Here in Canada, it's good morning for sure. Good evening and even good night and sweet dreams. All right. Okay, so we see your presentation. So please repeat.
I will show, in this presentation I will show you how we use EMS simulator in order to calculate the force stroke curve of our electromechanical actuators. Oops. Just a moment, because I have a little bit. Okay, so let's start with a brief introduction. Visa Hydraulics is a company born in 2009, specialized in the production of cartridge valves. We offer different kind of products, and we also offer electromechanical actuators. Electromechanical actuators are divided substantially into two great families, on-off solenoid valves or proportional solenoid valves. In the case of an on-off actuator, you have substantially two working conditions or positions, on or off, closed or open, depending on the presence or absence of the coil excitation. In a proportional solenoid valve, on the other hand, you have different working points, depending on the amount of current injected in the coil. In fact, here you have an external controller that tune the current injected in the coil by means of a P1 modulation, and accordingly to an input signal provided by a controller or a joystick or another ECU in the system. And in this way, you can tune the magnetic field produced by the coil and so the force acting on the plunger inside the valve. In this way, you can regulate the opening or closing percentage of your actuator and so regulate the flow or the pressure inside an hydraulic circuit, for example. In both cases, for the designer, it's very important to have an estimation of the magnetic field developed by the solenoid, study the magnetic flux inside the device in order to understand how efficiently your structure, so your pole tube and the coil armature are able to drive the magnetic flux and determine the force acting on the plunger. In this way, you are able to know the behavior of your actuator in its working conditions. So we need a software able to study the magnetic field at low frequency in our case. And so among all your available instruments, we choose EMS. So as we have already said, an electromechanical actuator is composed by a coil and the valve. And its working condition in every time instant depends on the equilibrium between different elements in the system. Specifically, you have a force due to the oil pressure, a force due to the spring, the force due to the magnetic field generated by the coil, and also secondary effects like, for example, friction that can be neglected in this analysis. And your unknown parameter is the force, and you are interested in estimate the force along the entire admitted stroke of the actuator. So you want to find the so-called force stroke curve. Let's start with the first application example. In this application example, we study the behavior of a proportional actuator. So proportional actuator has the goal to regulate the flow, in this case, the flow in a hydraulic circuit. To do this kind of study, starting from the complete structure in figure one, we have created a simplified model on SolidWorks, where are taken into account only the significant element of the device. So all the only the elements that participate in the magnetic simulation. So for what concerns the coil, we consider only the armature and the copper region. And for what concerns the valve, we consider the pole tube, the control cone, and the moving plunger. Then we also try to simplify the structure of the involved component, because maybe you can neglect some details that doesn't affect the simulation, but maybe makes the mesh creation more difficult. Then you need to create also a volume of air that surrounds the model. And then you can start by to configure the simulation. You have to assign material to each element, trying to find the element that best fit the behavior of the real element in your device. Then you have to define the coil in terms both of physical parameters, so the number of windings and the diameter of the wire, in order to estimate the filling factor of the copper area. And then also in terms of electrical excitation, so by defining the current injected in the coil, or maybe also the voltage, depending on the type of control. Then you have to define also the boundary conditions and define the element on which you want to calculate the force. You have also to create the mesh that can be a standard mesh or a refined mesh by means of mesh controls. And finally, you can launch the simulation. In this case, we have made a parametric simulation because we need to simulate the behavior for different current values. The first result that you obtain is in figure four, and substantially is the force calculated along all the three axes. And it's calculated for every scenario. The software creates obviously a different number of scenarios depending on the parameterized element, that in this case is the current. Then you can also study the magnetic flux density in figure five in order to evaluate how efficiently your device drive and confine the magnetic field. And then the first simulation is made with a fixed position of the plunger in the pole tube. If you change, if you repeat the simulation by changing the plunger position, you can obtain all the curves represented in figure six. Each of these curves is a FS curve, a force stroke curve, at a different current values. This substantially defines the behavior of the element of our device, because by combining the curves with the characteristic of the spring, you obtain some interception point, and each of these points represent a different working condition for the valve. Because from there, you know that if you inject a certain amount of current in the coil, you will have the plunger that moves of some quantity, and so you are able to tune the plunger position by changing the current, and so tune the opening percentage. To confirm the obtained results, we have also made a practical comparison with real data obtained by realize a sample. And as we may observe, the yellow curve in the figure seven that is representing the real data obtained with some test is really close to the simulated curve, meaning that our simulation is able to to simulate the real behavior of the element. A second application example regarding now an on-off actuator. So now an actuator where you have only two working positions, on or off, and is aimed to optimize the design in this case, because the shape of the curve depends on the pole tube, so the part of the valve composed by the this metal part and the control cone. The control cone that can be made by air or also different materials. And by changing the design of the control cone, you are able to tune the curve and maybe achieve specific behavior, specific performance. So what we have done here is, first of all, made a simulation like in the previous case, so following the same steps in order to find the FS curve corresponding to a specific design. That we have tried to make different models with different geometries for the control cone, trying to improve the performance of our device. What are the parameters that we want to regulate? Are the angle alpha and the position x represented in figure 9, because these are the responsible for the FS curve shape. So we have made a different simulation with different design, obtaining all these curves in figure 11. Our goal now is to maximize the force achieved in the first stroke part, so between 0 and 0.5 millimeter in this figure. And by analyzing different design, we have find a version of this pole tube that permits us to obtain this increased force, and is the geometry corresponding to this blue line that is that exhibits a much higher force to respect to the other cases. And also by observing the magnetic flux density in the left figures, we have observed that the case corresponding to the blue line exhibits also a higher peak of the magnetic flux density, meaning that this structure is more efficient in driving the magnetic flux density with respect to the other cases. So to conclude, with this simulator, we are able to, first of all, design different solutions in response to customer applications, because we receive a lot of customer requests. We also have some time saving in the repair process, because it's integrated in SolidWorks, that is our CAD. Then we are also able to estimate the force and also perform a design optimization in our studies. And then it seems to be also an helpful software for new product development. Thank you so much for the attention.